focus. You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased. All four evangelists record Jesus' baptism by John the Baptist, albeit with nuances of detail. Two themes are common to the four accounts: the presence of the Spirit in the form of a dove, and the voice that affirms Jesus as the beloved Son of God. John's baptism was merely a visible token of repentance administered by water alone, as a sign of purification in preparation for the Messiah. It prefigured sacramental baptism, which, in addition to the cleansing symbolism of water, significantly infuses the Holy Spirit, marks our adoption into God's family, and makes us co-heirs with Christ. The significance of the voice of God asserting Jesus' sonship cannot be overstated. It is expounded in today's second reading, culminating in verse 9. The title Son of God signifies the unique and eternal relationship of Jesus to his Father. A similar declaration was heard at the Transfiguration. Little wonder, then, that it forms a basic tenet of the faith we profess in the Apostles' Creed. If we truly believe what we profess and embrace in practice, what that adoptive relationship gifted to us through baptism entails, we could similarly earn our Father's approval. It is one worth working towards. Fruit. I will strive to understand the true significance and implications of the sacrament of my baptism.